Invasive species. Control. Organisms tend to live in one general area on Earth. They may find it hard to spread to new places because of their size or because of barriers like mountains, oceans, deserts, and rivers. Most species are very well suited for where they have developed and live. Sometimes organisms do move to new areas. It may take a long time for a species to expand its range, or it can happen quickly if conditions in the environment change. Some species move to new areas naturally, but in many cases humans are involved. Just because a species is introduced to a new habitat does not mean that it will reproduce, survive, and spread into other areas. However, there are times when species adapt very well to their new surroundings. They may have no predators, parasites, diseases, and/or competitors that were present in their native habitat. Often, when species move to an area where they don't normally live, they can cause many problems. An invasive species is one that is not native to a particular ecosystem and that does or is likely to cause harm to the environment and/or the economy. Invasive species control. The most effective means to stop invasive species is to prevent them from being introduced and established. In Illinois, the Wildlife Action Plan sets goals and actions for conservation across the state, including an invasive species campaign. The invasive species campaign identifies those actions determined to be most needed for statewide management of all groups of invasive species. Prevention includes education and outreach to raise the awareness of the invasive species problem and reduce the chance of unintentional introduction of invasive species. When invasive species are present, a variety of actions are taken to control or eradicate them based upon the behavior and life history of the species, as well as where it lives. To be most effective, a combination of several of these techniques may be required. Cutting, burning, digging, mowing, flooding, and/or pulling are techniques used on some invasive exotic plants. Spraying chemicals on the plants to kill them or on their cut stalks to eliminate the parts underground may be necessary. Removing an invasive plant out of its habitat is a start towards control, but what do you do with it after you remove it? Some plants can continue to develop seeds even after you remove them from the soil. Some of them can grow not only from seeds, but also from plant parts. You need to dispose of invasive plants properly. Placing them in a home compost pile or bin may not work. These compost piles may not get hot enough to kill the plants and seeds. If they don't, then you are spreading the invasives when you use the compost. Probably the best method for you to use as an individual is to bag the plants and place them with other waste for disposal in a landfill. If you are removing invasive plants from a large area of private or public property, you should check with local authorities about disposal procedures before you start removing plants. Removing the habitat that supports a species can lead to the elimination of the species. For example, the more ash trees that the emerald ash borer kills, the fewer places it will have remaining to live. When the ash trees are gone, the pest will also be gone. Ash tree seeds have been saved in seed banks to start growing these plants again once the infestation of emerald ash borers is finished. Invasive species often spread quickly in a new location because there are no predators that have evolved to help control them. Biological control involves releasing a natural predator from the invasive species' native habitat into its new habitat. Animals, fungi, or diseases can be used for biological control. Much study must be conducted before releasing another exotic species into the habitat. Cultural control is managing a forest or other area to control invasive species when they are present or to limit their effects if they have not arrived but are expected. For example, trees that the invasive species will live in or use for food and/or reproduction can be eliminated or greatly reduced in numbers to limit the number of the invasive species that can live in that area. Trees that are resistant to the invasive species could be planted, although it will take them a long time to grow. Asian carp are providing a challenge to control. They are aquatic, They feed by filtering food from the water, and there are enormous numbers of them. Control measures have included making them into a source of income. They are in demand for use as food in Southeast Asian countries. They can also be made into fertilizer, pet food, and other products. Americans tend to dislike eating them, but if they can be persuaded to do so, a cheap source of protein is available in our rivers. It may be impossible to eliminate an invasive species once it becomes established in an area. In that case, reducing its density enough to allow native species to survive can be the goal. When prevention doesn't work, detecting the presence of new invasive species in an area is critical to their control. The sooner a response effort is made, the better will be the chance of eliminating their presence or slowing their spread. Early detection of new infestations requires regular monitoring of the managed and surrounding area. Legislators have a role in control of invasive species too. They can set policies and enact laws to stop possession and commerce of invasive species. They can provide funding for invasive species research, education, and elimination too.